Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy. Welcome back to more Okamiden. In the last episode, we went through probably the most tedious area in the entire Ice Rim dungeon. And in this episode, we are going to be pressing on down this river. Now, starting off right here, I'm going to be in my informative persona because it is very, very, very imperative that you know something. You do not want to melt ice in this river unless you have to. If you melt ice in this river, you could potentially screw yourself out of a collectible forever. It is possibly the most jerkish game design they have done so far. I'll admit that while you don't need these items to beat the game, you do need them for 100%, and while this isn't the worst case of missable collectibles I've seen, probably the worst case I would say are the Tales of games, because god, every side quest you need a guide for if you want to be able to... Tales of games, you need a walkthrough to 100% them. You can't tell me that you 100%ed a Tales game without a walkthrough, with how easily you can miss side quests. Like, they put stuff like on the other side of the frickin' world when the next place you're supposed to go is like two steps away from where a cutscene places you. The thing that you could have missed is in Isu Masterpiece Part 5. So it is imperative that you know this. We're gonna go ahead and jump onto that, and let's flip by just a little bit longer. And is there really anything else for us to do? We can't really go down that way. There is an island back there, which I'm kind of curious about. I honestly don't know how to get to it. And, okay, that was kind of weird. So, yeah. I think that actually does it for collectibles. You have the history scroll going home. You have the ice boulder. The blue head, the ice beast, the clay soldier, the clay samurai, the death beast, and the spark beast. I was getting the name wrong. All in your bestiary. Have all those, you are golden. You do not need to worry about collectibles for the rest of this dungeon. Also, there is a lucky coin here, but I don't really think it's overly necessary to point it out because it is useless if you have everything like I do and you've been playing along. So, going onward! This thing is really freaking cool! Wow, a dinosaur frozen ice. You don't think it's still alive, do you? Yeah, really freaking awesome, if I do say so myself. I'm saying it like I rendered it and textured it and everything, which I did not. I don't know where that fit in. But either way, going on here, we have probably one of my personal favorite puzzles in Okamiden coming up. Which, if we go over here, we'll actually get a taste of it. Remember that magnet power that we didn't remember having? Well, we actually have some pulleys and elevators that are powered by magnets that we gotta use to get across. I love this idea, and I really hope that they flesh out this idea a bit more in further sequels of the Okami series. Because I really think that the magnet power, they kind of only scratched the surface with it this time around. It could have gone a lot further. And it's only effective on a few enemies. It's effective on quite a few bosses, but not on every enemy, I'll say that much. Like, there's very few enemies that it seems to work well on. As you see here, we are actually stuck. This one cannot move forward on its own, so we have to time our jump through. No, not to try you. Draw an N. Okay. So we go through here. And we got a chest, which gives us a Divine Sake L. Not bad. In fact, I think I will actually put my Holy Bone L on a shortcut right here, just so that I don't forget. And I think I'll also equip my Exorcism Fire there as well. So now that we've crossed through there, I really hope that they flesh out puzzles like that later in the game. Because I think that idea has potential, they just don't really use it that much. But, heading all the way up here, we've reached the top. I see a treasure chest over there. Hey, you think we can find the amber there? Pointless cutscene is pointless! What else could be in there? No, actually, it was a pearl. Dang, it wasn't the amber we needed. Looks like there's nothing else up here for now. We'll have to try our luck somewhere else. So, because we can't do anything else, I guess we'll just have to give up and go home. Monpuku's mom is gonna get eaten. World is doomed. No one is here to save us because Ami never showed up. And, well, we're just some kids. We can't do anything on our own. So, wow, I really did die. Oh, come on! Now, on the way back, just as a tip, you should probably save your data. Not just for sake of saving, but also because you want to get your health and ink restored. So, with all that done, let's head out here. Meet Mizuchi, a water dragon. I don't know what it is with Okami and water dragons, but nonetheless, a water dragon that, according to legend, existed in prehistoric times. He is completely impervious to your attacks right off the bat. If you wander away from him, you'll see a cannon back here and... Wow, okay, way to screw my explanation. You'll see a cannon back here, which you can actually put Monpuku inside, just like any other cannon. However, doing this right off the bat actually kind of leads to something a bit humor... Wow, I can't... Wow, I am really not doing so well right off the bat. Now, this is kind of a bad idea, but honestly, I think this is kind of funny. If you light the fuse right here and launch Monpuku right off the bat, this happens. I don't know why, I just always thought that was so funny looking. But you want to pick him up quick because he's down to only one unit of health, and of course, if he dies, it's an instant game over. So, what we gotta do is, we're gonna just dodge his attacks. When he freezes his ice like that, you need to just stay back. When he launches icicles down, you just need to keep running. Nothing as simple as that. Okay, I really need to step up my game a bit. I'm getting my ass kicked here. Okay, so eventually, what's going to happen is, he's going to use a certain attack after we hit him around a little bit. Come on, do that certain attack. Come on. Okay, now he's impervious to our attacks. I'm getting... Okay, seriously. Eventually, that will pop out of the ceiling. When you do that, he is trapped. Now is your chance to get into the cannon, launch Monpuku out of it, and have him hit Mizuchi in the face. Mizuchi is... actually kind of challenging, I'll admit. He is not one of the easier enemies that you'll be fighting here in Okamiden. He is stuck. Hitting him in the face with Monpuku is incredibly effective and will do a lot of damage. However, he goes back to being just as invulnerable as he was before. Staying right here in the middle, not going off to the side, and using your dodge backwards is incredibly effective in this fight. Otherwise, you likely will get hit quite a bit like I was. So, we want to go ahead and... a little bit more. And there we go, we got out of the way of that. I honestly use the dodge more in this fight than I do in the rest of the game, which is kind of funny. Doing that, he's going to bring down some icicles, which you can just run away from. And let's see if we can do a bit more to him. Nope, we can't. I'm going to let it roar. That was wonderful. Okay, let's stop sucking a bit, and let's attack. That's going to do that to him. And now that he's trapped... put Monpuku into the cannon. Let's light the fuse. And take out a good 10% of his health. Let's, you know what? I actually equipped that Exorcism Fire for a reason. Let's see if it actually does anything. Nope. Doesn't look like it. So, let's get out of the way of this attack. Attack him a few more times. Bit of a pattern, you know. All bosses usually have them, of course. You know what? I'm gonna equip a Steel Fist Sake right here just because I haven't been doing a whole lot of damage to him and I kind of want to speed things up a bit because he's actually been getting kind of dangerous. Power slash him right there. And unfortunately, he's actually, if you've been wondering, impervious to your attacks right there. So if you've been going like, you know, why don't you just attack him when he's stuck under the icicle? That is actually why. Him flailing about, you can't pierce it. So he has a lot of guarding abilities. Now, as you see right there, he has put up a wall of ice, throwing a bit of a monkey wrench into our whole plan. Using Fire Burst or Monkuku's Fire will get the job done. I just preferably like to do Fire Burst just because I think it looks cool. And that's just what I like doing. No, I don't. So, come on, let me attack you. I don't know why I sounded like I was singing there. I'm gonna roar again, bringing down those icicles, which always home in on you. I wish I could control my voice enough to make icicles come down in exactly the places I wanted them just from using sound waves. That'd be awesome. Still can't do any damage to him. He's actually especially defensive this time around. And we want to dodge back out of the way. Try down some more icicles, and let's see if we can get a little bit more damage in. Oh, no, 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 no. You are not getting me with that again. I'm going to attack you a bit more. Got out of the way of that. And we finally get to freaking attack him a bit more. For all that. He's going to try to use his breath on us once more. As you can tell, this fight is a little bit slow. Don't let it discourage you, though. It is, in my opinion, one of the greatest battles in Okamiden. It does get drag on for a bit, but I don't know. I kind of do enjoy this. I always look forward. This is one of those battles that I always look forward to every time I play through it. So, let's attack. Whoa! I want to use my Holy Bone L right there because I was running low on health. I do not want to die. Because it makes common sense to not want to die. Hit. Go, and I think that was actually enough. Yes! I was able to just hit him enough times to bring that up. Let's bring down the icicle onto him. Let's head back to the cannon. And let's fire our Monpuku! He's gonna try to bring up the wall of ice one more time. Let's divide by zero. Okay, that wasn't really so much dividing by zero. And hit him one final time for the final attack! I am surprised it did that well, frankly.
Oh, Dude, what?
Yeah,